Learning English helps me to talk about movies.
SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways throughout Australia. Hi, my name is Josipa, and one of my favorite things to do during warm summer nights is to catch a flick under the stars. To catch a flick means to go to the cinema to watch a movie. To be completely honest, I only found out about this phrase recently when Alan asked me,
"Do you want to catch a flick tonight?"
You could also say, "Do you want to catch a movie?" Or if you prefer going to the theater or a concert, you could ask your friends to catch a play or show with you. And after catching a movie at the cinema, you could catch a train, bus or taxi to get home. English is rather strange, isn't it? By the way, did you know that the word cinema comes from the ancient Greek kinema, meaning movement? The word cinema is actually a shortened version of the French word cinématographe, which combines the Greek word kinema with another Greek word graphien, which means to write or record. So when we talk about cinema, we are describing the recording of movement. Our friends, Alan and Claire, shared this knowledge with me. You know, they are real movie buffs. That is, they know a lot about films, and they go to the cinema every week. Let's hear what phrases they have for us today.
Let me see if Alan wants to go to the cinema.
Hi, Claire.
Hey, have you seen that new release that everyone is talking about?
The one with Kate Blanchett?
Yes. Everyone's been waiting for the premiere. It's the most hotly anticipated event this year.
No, I haven't seen it yet, but I've noticed a lot of buzz about it.
A couple of other releases have hit the cinema too, but I'm keen on seeing Kate's first. She always carries the film, and the rest of the cast is stellar.
I'm in, but unfortunately I can't do it tonight. Do you know how long it's running for?
Plenty of useful phrases. Let's start with Claire. She asked Alan if he had seen a movie that everyone was talking about by saying,
"Have you seen that new release that everyone is talking about?"
A new release is a film that is just being made available to the public. Do you remember what Claire said about the premiere of a movie she wants to see? The premiere is when a film, show, TV series or similar is shown or performed for the first time in front of an audience. Anyway, Claire said,
"Everyone's been waiting for the premiere. It's the most hotly anticipated event this year."
Everyone was waiting for it because they expect that it will be very good. And if an event, especially a cultural event, is hotly or highly anticipated, people look forward to it because they believe it will be exciting and interesting. We heard Alan saying that he hasn't seen this movie, but that he has heard about it. He used an interesting phrase that we can use in everyday situations. He said,
"There's a lot of buzz about it."
Buzz can mean many different things. For example, it's the sound bees make. Also, it can stand for a rumor, gossip, or if you tell someone, "I'll give you a buzz," you mean that you'll give them a telephone call. But if you say there's a lot of buzz about something, it means that there's a lot of excitement and conversation about it. People are very keen to see it.
A couple of other releases have hit the cinema too.
If a motion picture, which is another way of saying a movie, hits the cinema, it means that it has been released. It has also become available to the public. From our dialogue, it is very clear that Claire is a big fan of Kate Blanchett, an iconic Australian actor. And by iconic, I mean very famous and popular. Claire said,
"She always carries the film, and the rest of the cast is stellar."
When we say an actor carries the film, it means that we think that their acting makes the movie good, even if the other actors aren't so good. But in this case, Claire said that the rest of the cast is stellar too. The cast of a movie, play, or TV show is all the actors in it. And when the cast is stellar, all actors are stars. They're famous and popular, and usually very good. You could also say that someone's performance was stellar. We say this when we think that they have done very good work.
"I'm in, but unfortunately, I can't make it tonight. Do you know how long it's running for?"
The expressions "I'm in," or sometimes we say "count me in," mean that you want to be included in an activity that someone has suggested. Therefore, Alan said that he wanted to see the movie with Claire, but he couldn't do it tonight. Then he asked how long the film was running for. That is, how long the movie will be available in the cinema. How often do you go to the cinema? And what was the last movie you saw? Did you like it or not? What was good or bad about it? For our next dialogue, Alan and Claire are just coming out of the cinema. Let's see if they like the movie they saw.
"Wow, that movie was unbelievably good.
The opening scene was intriguing, and I loved the cast. I think this movie is going to be a big box office hit."
Alan described the movie as unbelievably good, meaning it was impressive and extremely good. You could also say that movie was gripping, or
"That movie was outstanding."
Claire then mentioned things she liked about the movie. Let's hear her again.
"The opening scene was intriguing, and I loved the cast."
The opening scene is the first part of the film, which Claire finds intriguing. Another way of saying so interesting that it made her very keen to keep watching and find out more.
"I think this movie is going to be a big box office hit."
A box office hit is a movie that is financially very successful because a large number of people buy tickets to watch it. Now, I'm really happy that Alan and Claire enjoyed the movie, but I wonder what phrases they would use if they didn't like it.
Hey, Josipa, you don't have to wonder. Claire and I saw plenty of dreary movies. They were really boring and not at all interesting.
Oh, yeah. There are quite a few movies out there that are second-rate and predictable. Definitely not the best, and with plots that are just too easy to guess.
And I'm not a fan of when they make a really riveting trailer for a movie that is really slow. For me, that's a letdown and a waste of time.
Thanks, guys. And Alan, now that you mentioned a letdown and a waste of time, you have reminded me that we have a whole episode on phrases we can use to talk about disappointment. You might want to check it out. It's episode number 25 called Talking About Disappointment. Now it's time to introduce our guest, but before I do that, I just want to quickly go over some other words you mentioned. Claire, you said that some movies were second-rate and predictable. What do you mean by that?
A second-rate movie is a movie that is not exciting and of very low quality. If a film is predictable, it is pretty clear what is going to happen next. There are no surprises.
And Alan, what was it you said about the trailer?
I said I'm not a fan when they make a riveting trailer for a slow-paced movie.
A movie trailer is a short promotional film composed of clips showing highlights of a movie. And if a trailer is riveting, it is very exciting. It keeps you watching, or as we say, glued to the screen. while in a slow movie, the main action develops very slowly. And if you are not a fan of something, it means you don't like it. You can use this phrase when talking about anything, not just movies. But let's say you just saw a movie you didn't like. You could say,
I wasn't a fan of this movie.
Our guest today is an Asian-Australian actor, Eric So, who gave a stellar performance in our video series Meet the Changs. If you haven't seen it yet, I encourage you to check it out on our website. It's funny and it will help you improve your English language skills. Eric, would you agree?
Absolutely. I had a great time working on it, and the series is absorbing with plenty of useful tips for migrants trying to settle in Australia.
Eric, I'm curious about your opportunities to work as an Asian Australian actor. It seems to me that we can see more diversity on TV and in the cinema in recent years.
Oh, it's much better than it used to be, but there is still more work we need to do as a society to be more inclusive. But you are right. Writers, directors, and actors from diverse backgrounds are getting more and more opportunities to tell their stories. For example, at the 2023 Berlin International Film Festival, one of the world's most hotly anticipated film festivals, there will be 7 new Australian works.
7? That's a big number. What kind of stories are we sending overseas?
There's a movie called Limbo by an Indigenous Australian filmmaker, Ivan Sen, or a series, Bad Behaviour, directed by Corey Chen, which features young Australian-Asian actress Yeren Ha. Rolf de Heer's The Survival of Kindness will also have an international premiere in Berlin, and it has a multicultural cast. So yes, increasingly, Australian entertainment industry is becoming more inclusive.
That's great to hear. Well, thank you for your time today, Eric. Much appreciated.
Thank you for inviting me. It was my pleasure.
Oh, but I'm not letting you go yet. Will you help us repeat phrases we practiced in this episode?
Sure, let's do it.
See if you can remember the meaning before hearing the answer. What does it mean to catch a flick?
To catch a flick means to go to the cinema or to watch a movie. For example, let's catch a flick tonight.
If something is hotly anticipated or highly anticipated, it is
an event is hotly or highly anticipated, people are looking forward to it because they believe it will be exciting and interesting.
We heard different phrases we can use when talking about going to the cinema. You can practice by repeating after Alan and Claire.
Have you seen that new release that everyone is talking about?
There's a lot of buzz about that movie.
A couple of new releases have hit the cinema.
We also heard some useful phrases we could use to talk about movies.
The cast is stellar and the movie was outstanding.
I think this movie will be a big box office hit.
Some movies are second-rate and predictable.
I wasn't a fan of this movie.
In this episode, we covered more valuable phrases, which you can find under the learning notes on our website. You can also read the transcript and test your listening and understanding skills with our quiz. You know that we love to hear from you. Get in touch through our Facebook page. We are SBS Learn English. I'm your host, Josipa. Thank you for learning English with me.
SBS Learn English helps Australians speak, understand, and connect.